magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Stand alone, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna. Blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, hallelujah, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my praise, God, for he is truly worthy. And today we're going to talk about Palm Sunday. What is Palm Sunday? Palm Sunday is a Christian movable feast that falls on the Sunday before Easter. The feast commemorates Jesus' triumphal entrance into Jerusalem, an event mentioned in all four canonical gospels. In many Christian churches, Palm Sunday includes a procession of the assembly worshipers carrying palms, representing the palm branches the crowd scattered in front of Jesus as he rode into Jerusalem on a donkey. The difficulty of protruding palms in unfavorable climate leads to their substitution with branches of native trees, including box, yew, willow, and olive. The Sunday was often designated by the name of these trees, Ad and Yew Sunday, or by the general term, Branch Sunday. In the account of the four canonical gospels, Jesus' triumphant entrance into Jerusalem takes place about a week before his resurrection. The symbolism is captured in Zechariah 9 and 9, the coming of King of Zion's King. See, your King comes to you, righteous and victorious, lowly and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. It was perceived that Jesus was declaring he was the king of Israel to the anger of the Sanhedrin. According to the gospel, Jesus rode a donkey into Jerusalem, and the celebrating people there laid down their cloaks in front of him and also laid down small branches of trees. The people sang part of Psalm 118, 25-26, 25. Save now, I beseech thee, Lord. O Lord, O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. Blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you out of the house of the Lord. Psalm 118, 25 and 26. Who would believe in a few days they would be hanging him high on a cross? And instead of the people being joyful and shouting Hosanna to their king, they would be shouting, crucify him. The symbolism of the donkey may refer to the Eastern tradition that it is an animal of peace versus the horse, which is the animal of war. A king came riding upon a horse when he was bent on war, and rode upon a donkey when he wanted to point out he was coming in peace. Jesus' entry to Jerusalem would thus symbolize his entry as the Prince of Peace, not as the war-waging king. Amen? The symbolism that we find in scriptures is wonderful. And we thank God for giving us the interpretation. In Luke 19:41, as Jesus approaches Jerusalem, he looks at the city and weeps over it. An event known as Felvo Super Ilum in Latin, foretelling the suffering that awaits the city. In many lands in the ancient Near East, it was customary to cover in some way the path of someone thought worthy of the highest honor. The Hebrew Bible, 2 Kings 9:13, reports that Jehoash, son of Jehoshaphat, was treated this way. Both the Synoptic Gospels and the Gospel of John report that people gave Jesus this form of honor. However, in the Synoptic, that are only reported as laying their garments and cut rushes on the street, whereas John specified front of palms, Greek phonics. In Jesus' tradition, the palm is one of the four species carried for sukkah as prescribed for rejoicing at Leviticus 23:40. The palm branches was a symbol of triumph and victory in the Greco-Roman culture of the Roman Empire and became the most common attribute of the goddess Nyx, or victory. For contemporary Roman observers, the procession would have evoked the Roman triumph. When the triumphant laid down his arms and wore the toga, the civilian garment of peace that might be ornamented with emblems, the palms. Although the epistles of Paul refers to Jesus as triumphing, the entry into Jerusalem may not have been regularly pictured as a triumphal procession in this sense before the 13th century. In ancient Egyptian religion, the palm was carried in funeral procession and represented eternal life. The palm branch later became a symbol of Christian martyrdom and their spiritual victory or triumph over death. In Revelation 7:9, the white chaff multiplied strand before the throne and the lamb holding palm branches. In the 16th and 17th century, Palm Sunday was marked by the burning of jack-o'-lantern figures. This was a straw effigy which would be stoned and a brew. Its burning on Palm Sunday was often supposed to be a kind of revenge on Judas Iscariot, who had betrayed Christ. It could also have represented the hated figure of winter, whose destruction prepared the way for spring. So much symbolism. Eastern and Oriental Christianity, Palm Sunday, or the entry of the Lord into Jerusalem, as it is often called in some Orthodox churches, is one of the 12 great feasts. Several groups turned out to see Jesus in the days just prior to his death. Some Jews still believed he was about to set up an earthly political kingdom. Others, especially the Pharisees, opposed Jesus. Jesus proclaimed his kingship with an entry suitable for a king in Jerusalem. He engaged the leaders and common folks alike in final words of teaching. He explained why he had to die and summarized his overall message. We would see Jesus. It is a blessed thing for a man when he has brought all his desires into a focus so that they all centered on one object. When he has 50 different desires, his heart resembles a mere of stagnant water spread out into a marsh, bleeding, mima, and pestilence. But when all his desires are brought into one channel, his heart becomes like a river of pure water. Happy is he who has one desire, if that desire be set on Christ, though it may not yet have been realized. If Jesus be a soul's desire, it is a blessed sign of divine work within. Is this thy condition, my brothers and sisters, at this moment? Hast thou but one desire, and that is after Christ? Then thou art not far from the kingdom of heaven. Hast thou but one wish in thy heart, and that one wish that thou mayest be washed from all thy sins in Jesus' blood? Canst thou really say, I would give all I have to be a Christian? I would give up everything I have and hope for, if I might but feel that I have an interest in Christ? Then despise all thy fears. Be of good cheer. The Lord loveth thee, and thou shalt come out into daylight soon, and rejoice in the liberty wherewith Christ makes men free. Amen. In what circumstances do you find it most difficult to believe that Jesus will protect and provide for you? Let today be your prayer day. At the top of each hour, commit yourself more completely to the Savior by taking a moment to pray. Amen. Father God, we thank you for this lesson today about Palm Sunday. Bless your people. Open up their ears to hear and bless the peace of Jerusalem. Amen, amen, amen.